रामा जो है नमः इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटेशंस फ्रॉम वेरियस सिविलाइजेशंस फ्रॉम वेरियस डिफरेंट प्लेसेस वी आर सीइंग अ मिनी यूनिवर्स हियर वी आर इनसाइड a small microcosmic structure which in future should permeate into the macrocosmic structure creating universal order peace and harmony and talking about civilization is second beautiful and lovely gift of God the first being creation the first gift given by God is creation shows the splendor of God's abilities as well as his boundless mercy and affection on all of us and the second thing that he has instigated is the civilization that is the second work in theo architectonics so civilization is a god given gift of four major components which are known as hope resources tools and opportunities for development so civilization according to definition there are three stages of the civilization which we call as mature semi mature and super mature or hyper mature the mature stages of civilization the first stage of civilization what we call generally refinement is moral supremacy or superiority where we know how to control ourselves to be distinguishable from beasts to have the real incorporated instincts of the divine bestowal how to organize ourselves and to organize our fellow beings the power to control oneself and to organize a group that started with civilization that is delegation self control which are all nothing but the forms of moral supremacy this is the first stage and the second stage is what we call semi stage of civilization or semi maturity in which the status of living is developed in the form of residence transportation then communication by means of gesticulations signals symptoms emblems language script etc which we call samgya sanketa bhasha lipi in sanskrit so this is also something and then acquaintance with resources and tools these are all semi maturity in civilizations the real hyper maturity or the benchmark of a civilization is to understand to care and concern for one's own fellow beings and to believe submit and serve god this is to be the hallmark of civilization so the civilization reaches its culmination whenever a person thinks about the fellow beings and their totalitarian development or collective survival along with the thinking of the primary force for our survival establishment and proceedings that is the form of the ultimate or universal spirit god believing him surrendering and service so this is what we call the model of the society which is the evolution in the forms of social economical political and spiritual first the society developed then the expansion of the society that has passed in the exploration of resources for survival and betterment then this type of exploration has resulted in clash and conflicts in sharing of power and resources which has created a political administrative system in power sharing of governance there has created lot of conflicts and misunderstandings and wars the discriminations which are to be washed away by a totalitarian development of ultimate and immaculate consciousness in the form of spiritual awakening This is somehow connected with the Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudrotpadana of our system, not being very much congenitally, but systematically, sociologically. It forms the social community, then the economic resources are balanced by the other community, then administration by community, then the spiritual upliftment by the ultimate community like that. It can also take the reverse order, like the spiritual system governs the, it should govern the administration. The administration should be proper to get proper healthy resources. Only proper distribution and accommodation of healthy resources create a healthy society. So this is how we have to understand. And it is also connected with the theories. There is a conflict theory as well as the integration theory of people like Dr. Elwin Sarvis and Dr. Barrett and Dr. Markhan Freud. These people, they culminated a theory which is known as the theory of people who are known as gangsters and hunters. That band. Then the pastoral band, then the chiefdoms, and also the priesthood, clergy, and other people. Now coming to the present point, what is the reason for construction of all of these forms in the form of seminars, conferences, symposia, get together a research analytical studies about civilization. That which has happened before thousands of years and that which is diminishing and obsolete, what is the reason for the revival? It is to reconstruct the society, to regain the same glory, because science is not the substitute. Technology is not the substitute. And mere political unilateral development is not the substitute. Mere erudition or perspicacity or knowledge development and epistemological reach cannot be the substitute unless the person's mind setup and mutual reality and bondage and affinity, if they are not properly constructed, that can be brought only by civilization, because science and technology is never in the form or component or a compound of the so-called civilization, and we cannot include the science and civilization totally to be something parallel or coherent at all. We cannot even imagine. So regaining the glory and revival of the civilization is the only way for bringing back the glory of tranquility and prosperity, real tranquility and prosperity in the society. So we have to reconstruct. Everybody is now talking about the clash of civilizations, what will happen in the future because of various socio-political, religious, economical issues, what will happen to the society. Everybody is very much bothered about those things. Like there are a lot of writers like Oswald Spengler, then Arnold Toynbee, and Samuel Huntington. A lot of the people, they have researched on all of these things. They concerned about the genesis, how they evolved through migration, trade, which is everything known to all of the other people, by invasions, how it is done. But regarding the contemporary thing, what to do? Number one, I've already told, technical development and scientific development is an additive or a supportive factor to already existing mind setup. If a person is constructive, the technical tool will be also constructive. It takes the shape of the mind setup of a person. So it is not reliable contemporarily. Even we have to say that these developments are very much unilateral and dangerous, pernicious to the present mind setup theory of the society. Then what to do? Because of two major factors, we have to analyze the present mind setup in two major divisions because of these two factors. Even those who are very much crude, they used to be customized by development. For example, even if I am bad, by means of domestication, like we are doing for animals, in domestication, exposure to the society, exposure to society, mingling with people, then getting into transformation. The first thing is domestication by means of tuition and training. Second thing is transformation by exposure of the pains and pressures of the society. Third thing is realization, which is a divine bestowal. Even the crude barbarian civilizations, if they are properly exposed, if they want willingly to be exposed, they can be mesmerized, materialized, and they can, their levels can be minimized, and they can be also brought into the level of understanding things with softness, delicacy, and divinity. And even good people or cultured people, if they are exposed to adulteration, dilution in the traditional standards, we are also examples for that. Adulteration due to various cultural infusions and mixtures, and dilutions because of our traditional lineage, what we call vichinna. We want avichinna, uninterrupted lineage. Now we are in vichinna sthiti. That is, we are subjected to intrusion and breakdown. That is the second thing. And third thing is coercion. Due to some compulsions of the environmental situations, even good religions, good cultures, they are put into turmoil. So in order to bring a good order to all of these things, we have to think about the future. The ancient historians or civilization mechanics, they told there are three opportunities for the future. One is a barbarization. Second thing is conventional world system. Our third thing